This is the house that Johnny lived. Within it was an untouchable empire. Johnny was surrounded by his boys, who were bound by unconditional loyalty. Whatever Johnny wanted was handled by the boys. It was the law. Of course, everything looked good on paper, thanks to Shifty Rabinowitz. He handled all the cash. The only paper pushing we ever did was during our poker games. Like a religion we played. Nobody ever missed a game. There was Tony. He had Johnny's back, like a guardian angel or something. That's why we called him Tony the Shadow. Then there was Paulie One Look. Cheating bastard. He was either looking at your cards or looking at your wife. Then there was Mickey Three Fingers. They called him that because if you had to deal with him, you'd be lucky if you had three fingers left. And finally, the Poker Messiah. I swear, he pulled cards out of his ass. We called him Tony Five Diamonds. He was Johnny's right-hand man. The family was a tight circle that nobody could break. Johnny didn't trust nobody. Well, except for his two pups, that big cannoli thing, and that little shit, Eisenstein. And of course, his sister Marie. We all called her Angel Face. She was a singer at a club downtown. One day, when Johnny got word from Paulie that his sister wasn't being treated right by his slime ball manager, it was time for a night on the town for us. Yeah, that's right. When Rabinowitz and Johnny showed up at the club, we was already there waiting. That was all Johnny needed to give the word. He told Tony. Tony told Five Diamonds. Five Diamonds already had the plays rigged up. He went over to the bar and passed the word to the bartender, Louis Love Handles. Louis gave a look to his partner, Martini, and Martini gave the word to Three Fingers. Yeah. Three Fingers had already set it up with the pimp. And Five Diamonds pulled out the bait. A bait that nobody could resist. That's right. Vicky the Vixen. And little did Slimeball know, he was going down for the ride of his life. That was that. A job well done, followed by the proper celebration.